after taking a break, just a 1 week break, we're playing again this weekend. Yeah. We play a team that we never beat in the Premier League. Also, we're playing a team that we can say is fighting the relegation. And that makes it a bit more dangerous. So tell me, what kind of encounter are you expecting?
That's a difficult one.
Truly, they are relegation threatened. And as of now, they are like wounded lions. You don't go to such a team, more especially at their home, expecting an easy game. Because normally, the team at home is always having the upper hand. So they'll come at you with everything they have to make sure they pick a point. But I think we have the caliber of players with that mental strength to withstand every difficulty on the field. So we are going in there also to fight and at least come out with 3 points.
And how desperately do you need all the points on the weekend?
To be frank, we need the 3 points. This 3 points is the most important one. Of all the points we have picked, I think this is the most important 3 points we need more than ever. One, because it will put us in a secure place among the top 8 and hopefully to push us to the top 4. And secondly, it's the 3 points that we need to run away from those behind us. So I think it is the most important one to put us in a safe position before we meet the last 4 games.
And let's talk about this. The past 3 consecutive games, we didn't win. We just kept on drawing. So how is the pressure on you guys that you need to win this game?
I don't think there's pressure on us. If you put pressure on yourself, you go in making mistakes. A game has 3 outcomes. Win, draw, or you lose. And I think drawing these past 3 games have not been that bad. It's good for us. We have seen where we need to beef up. We have seen where we need to adjust. And I think currently we are in position to say we can go in there and fight for 3 points.
Coach, 2 of our players have been called to the national team. And from the conversation I had yesterday, it's like the program that they are doing with the national team is different from what we are doing here. So does that affect your players or your plans with other coaches?
We try to talk to the national team to try to find out the programs that they have at the national level, so that when the players go, we know they go there 3 days in a week. When they go, at least we know for the physical fitness, they may have it. The tactical, because of the game plan of the national side, may be a bit different from what we have. But when they come to us the Thursday and Friday, we are able to adjust and use them accordingly in the team.
Are we going to see any changes in the starting lineup different from what you saw when we were playing LDF?
Yes, I think there will be 1 or 2 changes. More especially on the grounds that some of our players are on yellow cards, 4 yellow cards. So I think there will be 1 or 2 changes because of the sanctions that we have and the suspensions.
As the technical team, are you happy that Motlalepula Tshabedi will be back on Saturday's game?
Every player's impact is very good to us as coaches because you plan around the 25-28 players you have. And each game, if you have all your players, is a bonus to you as a coach. So Chavedi's coming back is a big boost to the team, especially the forward line.
We are playing in Butawuti, and last time we played Sandawana, we lost. And I do think it's because of the crowd. It doesn't suit the playing style that we use here. Isn't that a big problem to you as coaches that we're going to the field which is not good and we are used to playing, I can say, tick a tick.
Yeah. In the third world country, every field is a problem. We are fortunate to have the five-a-side field where we are able to play the passing game. But I think LDF and LMPS games might have given us something to stand on before going to that field, because it is not like our five-a-side where we always have that passing game. It gave us a lesson which I think will help us to cope with that field better than we did the previous time.
Okay, and then Mako, looking at our position right now, we're still fighting for the top 8 spot. Do you see yourselves winning that battle in the Premier League and making it into the top 8 next season?
Yeah, I mean, we do have potential to be the top 8 this season. We are fighting, and I do believe if we get maximum points in the remaining games, we will stay in the top 8 and maybe possibly in the top 4.
And we play in the Killer on Saturday, a team that we never won against, on a pitch that we never won still again.
Yeah.
Tell me, how are you guys going to approach that game?
Well, as to how we're going to approach the game, that will be the job of the coaches. I mean, they'll tell us on how to approach the game. But then we know the Killer, we've played against the Killer before, and we know that they are good. They are good, they are a strong team, and they are fighting relegation, so they are going to come at us at all costs. So, but then we'll play and we'll give it our best.
And you're one of the best attacking midfielders, I can say, in the country. We've seen you doing well in the team. You scored your only goal against LMPS. Are we yet to see more goals from you?
Well, yeah. Yeah, you are going to see more goals. I mean, I'm working on my goal scoring skills. I'm working on, you know, my striking abilities, and I do believe that there will be more goals in the next coming games.
Still on the goal scoring and the striking forces, on which areas you as a player do you think you need to work on?
In which area do I think I need to work on?
In the field, yeah.
In the field. I'm a left winger, so basically I need to work on my position as a left winger. So, yeah.
Okay, let me say, which do you think are your weaknesses in the field?
My weaknesses? Okay, well, I think, you know, I'm playing the Premier League, I'm playing against the big guys, like you see, I'm still young, so my weakness in the field, it's not a weakness, I can only say, it's just that I'm still too young, so these guys are big, so my problem right now, it's marking, I get difficulties in marking these guys, so yeah, I think that's my only weakness right now.
Okay, Nerimoko, you are one player from a Kick4Life FC development team.
Yeah.
How does that make you feel that amongst many players that are in the academy, that you are one of the players that have been promoted to the team?
Well, I feel really good about that. I feel really honored to be promoted into the first team. So I guess that's all I can say.
How does it make you feel to have worked with good coaches like Ndatemo Talepula Majoro, now you're working with Melizi and Ndatele Slinoti?
Well, really, I'm really thankful to have, you know, met Ndatemo Talepula, as you say. He really taught me a lot as a player. He taught me how to behave, you know. he made me believe in myself. He made me believe that I can really do it in the big league. And Mamlizi, Leslie as well, they brought that confidence in me. And yeah, I guess that's what I can say.
My opinion is, you are one player who is good on taking on defenders. But I don't see you doing that regularly. And I think that's your strength.
Yeah.
What can you say about that?
I've been taking on defenders ever since I knew myself, you know, playing from the development team. I've been taking on defenders. But then when I came to the senior team, the whole thing changed, because the way the senior team was playing, the way my previous coach wanted me to play, he didn't want me more on taking on the defenders. He just wanted players who take the ball, pass the ball to the next person, you know, that kind of play. And then somehow my taking on defender skills, they somehow suffered in that. But then I'm still trying to get them back now as my new coach now, just give us the freedom to play how we can play. Just to play the normal game that we play, to be ourselves and just do anything that will help the team.
Will our supporters see you more taking on defenders, because that's where you are dangerous and very good in the coming games if you get the chance to play?
Yes, indeed, they will see me taking on defenders more often.
You are part of the National Under 20 team. Do you think the experience that you are getting from the National Under 20 team helps you when it comes to the Premier League?
Yeah, it does help me a lot. I mean, it really helps me boost my confidence playing the Premier League. And also the experience, the international games that we play give me experience on how to tackle the big players. Like, we do play with tough guys out there, and so yeah, that's the experience that I'm getting.
Let me take you back into last year, September, when you marked your debut against Dinar. Tell me, when the team was being called or was being introduced, and then you realized that you were on the starting lineup, what came to your mind? Because the way you approached the game, you approached it like somebody who's been playing before. You never showed any fear or anything that might hinder your performance in the field.
Yeah, well, you know, every day and every time, even though I did not play the previous games before that game came, I'm always ready. I'm always ready, like, to take any opportunity that I get. I'm always ready for every game and any game that I play. So that's why I came up with that performance. I said I was given this opportunity, I should grab it with both hands and work really hard.
And since then, you've been always on an exceptional performance. Since your debut against Dinari, you placed almost every game, if I'm not wrong. So, how do you manage to keep up the good performance that you display in the pitch?
Well, it's only about learning hard, the mistakes you made in the field. If you learn what you did good in the previous match, you learn the mistakes that you made, and then you learn from them. Every time when you go to the next game, you work on improving on what you have done before. So, and praying as well. Every time I always pray to God that may you give me the best performance than the one I had in the previous game. So that has worked for me.
Okay. And like my colleague here said, you're one of the good players who are good at taking defenses. And my opinion is that you are one amongst our players who can win us the games. Looking at your body physique, you might take on defense and they might commit fouls, more fouls often on the pitch. But we've never seen that happen anymore. Not taking much on the defense. How are you planning to work out on that going forward?
Well, like I said, my new coach right now has allowed us to play free, to do anything, to play our football, to do anything that will help the team win. So I'm working on that. Even in practice, I'm trying to work on that, take on defenders more often, because everything starts at practice. So I'm really working on it, and I think I will do it in the next coming matches.
Okay. And one last question from me.
Yeah.
And it's a random question.
Okay.
If I may say, who is the toughest defender that you ever faced in the Vodacom Premier League?
The toughest? Okay, well, the toughest defender that I ever came across is Muhum from Patalatan. I mean, I don't know. Actually, when I went to that game, I thought, you know, okay, Muhum was playing in the Hunters team when I was still growing up, so I knew him from there. I mean, I just said, yeah, Muhum, you know, I'm just going to go easy on him. He's just someone I know. I know he's not that good. He won't have anything on me. But then, it was different when I put him to the pitch. He didn't let me to play at all.
As a young player, I can see you're one of the most disciplined players and hardworking players in the team. What are your future ambitions?
Well, my future ambitions, I want to see myself playing in the big leagues. That's one thing. Yeah, representing the Soto as a whole and, you know, opening more doors for the Soto players. You know, show it out there that the Soto really does have talent and, yeah.
Looking at the work that Kick4Life FC as an organization do, what is your message to young boys that look up to you as a good player, as a role model?
Well, I say to them that, guys, you really need to work hard. I mean, you need to focus on what you want. You need to put all your mind, all your body, all your strength to what you love. And you need to be disciplined. That's one thing you really need to do. And then, yeah, I guess that's all I can say to them.
And Meli, one question from me again.
Okay.
And being realistic, I want us to be realistic here. We left with 5 games. Tequila, Bantu, Dihopo, Matlama and Judy. Out of 5, how many are you willing or are you wishing that you pick the maximum points? Just be realistic.
To be realistic, each game is not easy. It will be our wish to pick 15 points with the 5 games. But knowing that the league title, the decider is in our hands, we are not going to let it go just like that. We also need at least 12 out of the 15 games. So we need to go out there. For Diodi to win, they must beat us first. For Matama to win, they must beat us first. Which we are also willing to beat them to also end up in the top 4. Therefore, we are praying for the 15 points, but the minimum at least we should get 12 out of the 15.
Melizy, we saw last week Kick4Life holding coaching course here and some of our players being part of the trainees. Why were our players invited for that?
We are using some of our senior team players as academy coaches for the development side and the academy side. Therefore, we found it necessary to equip them from the scratch so that we have the quality training right from the beginning for the academy team. Therefore, we invited these players because they are the academy coaches so that we equip them. Starting from level 1, those who perform well will go on to the C that is coming in June, which we are still fighting for many spots, looking at the performance from the course. The performance, we have gone around the country for so many places for level 1 coaching course. I can confidently say that this is the best performance Lifa has got from any of the level 1 courses, both theory and practicals. Therefore, it is good to equip our academic coaches, even though they are still players, to take up and deliver quality training right from scratch.
And one more last question. Were you happy with the players' involvement, and do you think that will help them for their coming games, what they learned during the course?
Yes, I think most of the things, especially on the principles of the game, principles of defense, and principles of attack. With the number of players we have, about 4 or 5 of them that are still playing, taking them back to the principles, I think if they apply it in our coming games, it will be of great advantage to us as coaches and the team as a whole.
Thanks, Walter.
Thank you.